From the KATC Weather Lab, here's Rob's forecast.
Welcome back. Well, our weather pattern continues to look very nice over the next several days as we get closer to the weekend, feeling more like summer. It is still September after all, but it will feel a little bit closer to August by the time the weekend gets here, and no relief from the heat, no cool fronts in the forecast, but no tropical systems either. So we'll take it as a wash and move ahead. We still are looking at Irma, now finally down to a depression. That is the good news. Still producing heavy rainfall all the way up through Tennessee, more flood warnings. And notice how over the last, this is a 12-hour loop here, how the moisture has been spreading westward. And we see that high cloud deck off to our north and east. That's eventually going to be working its way into our part of the world, northern Louisiana tomorrow, and then perhaps Acadiana as we get into tomorrow night, Wednesday. But other than some clouds, we're not expecting much weather at all. Center of circulation right now on the Georgia-Alabama border here, and you can see with the wind field why they've had all these problems with the water coming up from Jacksonville all the way up through Charleston, even portions of North Carolina. And it's going to be another 24 hours before that water goes down. Again, this is a very large storm dealing with it, and it manifests differently every time on who's going to get the worst weather. For us, though, we're on the good side of the system, on the backside, and that means a nice northwest flow, and we'll continue to see that. Here's a six-day loop here I wanted to show you. This is Irma. This is Jose, and you can see how one massive storm here. This one set some pretty good hurricane records. Very large storm hits Cuba. That helped Florida out big time. So, but still, it's a potent system. At the end of the loop, the outflow from Irma influencing Jose, which was once a Category 4 storm, teetering on Category 5. And the last few frames burst here. And incidentally, the bulletins no longer being issued out of Miami for the tropics. It was shifted up to Maryland while the hurricane center was hit not only by the hurricane, but a lot of folks had homes here that had taken care of. Well, they're going to take over after tonight's bulletin on the tropical system. So all the advisors will come out of the National Hurricane Center. Jose now Category 1 storm, 85 mile per hour winds, expected to remain a hurricane over the next 5 days while it does a clockwise loop out in the Atlantic. After that, we do think it's going to turn northward. I don't think it's going to be a threat to the Gulf of Mexico. But as we look at our spaghetti plots, more of the models shifting to the east and up through the northeast. So East Coast is going to have to watch it. These model runs here were earlier today, European model runs. We think the European model will also follow the general cluster for tomorrow. So we'll keep an eye on Jose for now, but no Gulf threats, we think, at this point. So we start off the day with mostly sunny skies. That's the way it stays most of Acadiana. But notice that cloud deck from Irma still in the neighborhood as we go into tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow evening, we start to see more of the stratocumulus type clouds as we go into Wednesday as well. Model might even suggest a sprinkle or two. There we go. Maybe a quick hitting shower. 10% your rain chances, though, for Wednesday. Then we're back to sunny skies for Thursday. Deeper tropical moisture and humidity, that's going to be working its way northwestward as we get closer to the weekend. But we'll concentrate on the good stuff tonight. How about mid-50s the low, mid to upper 50s, northern parishes of Acadiana, upper 50s to near 60. It's unusual to see these temperatures this time of year for sure, so we'll take it and run, and upper 50s along the coast as well. So pleasant evening ahead, comfortable temperatures, light breeze, still window opening weather out there. Got to keep the screens, though, because the mosquitoes are still hitting. Tomorrow, another winter and mostly sunny and pleasant day. Few clouds to the north, but generally mostly sunny skies. 84 your projected high with a nice breeze out of the northwest, but not as breezy as it was today and yesterday. There's that 10% on the rain chance Wednesday. We might see more clouds. We'll have to wait and see on that. And then as we get toward the weekend, we notice those temperatures getting back into the uncomfortable zone. Overnight lows still not ridiculous, but getting back into the 70s, which will feel a lot more uncomfortable than the 59 degrees we're forecasting for tomorrow morning for Lafayette.
Yeah, this has been a pretty nice break.
Not bad
at all. It's held up, too.
Not bad at all. One day past the midway season.